Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, and today I'm going to show you a video using Volbella for lip injections and perioral rejuvenation, and it's approved up to 1 year duration, the first and only filler FDA approved for this area for that duration. Why? Uses Vicross technology, the sister product of Voluma, which we love, which is for mid-face filling, but it has a lower concentration. Instead of 20 milligrams per ml in Voluma of hyaluronic acid, we have 15 milligrams per ml, so it's a softer product. Now, we like to start in the upper face and lift. However, a lot of times we have to volumize and kind of fine-tune the lower area with a slightly different product than Voluma. A lot of people are used to mixing Voluma. However, you can't quite get the consistency perfect, so Volbella fits the bill. I also have a video using the under eye with Volbella, but today we're going to fill the lower lip, and I'm also going to go through anatomical kind of landmarks that we use to get a great result, because we want a natural result, not a ducky unnatural result, and that is what Volbella does. A natural, long-lasting results. Pick your patients carefully and look at some of the anatomical things I'm going to talk to you about to ensure a great, beautiful result. Let's go to the video now. Okay, so we're going to inject Juvederm Volbella today. Open up, just going to cleanse a little bit. This is a brand new product, Volbella. It's been in Canada, it's been in 70 other countries. It's new to the USA, and it's the first and only product that's FDA approved to last up to 1 year for not only lip volumization, but also for vertical lip lines or perioral rejuvenation. Now, the product is 15 milligrams per ml of hyaluronic acid, but most importantly with patients is to look at the anatomy and decide what we're going to do. Here, I want to look at the bottom lip compared to the top. We want a nice 1.61:1, or that golden ratio of the bottom lip bigger than the top. I'm assessing the philtrum columns, and they look great. Let's get the patient to animate. So whistle or purse your lips. So no vertical lip lines, that helps us out. And the mouth is very neutral to upturned. So our job becomes easier because it's we don't need to help with rejuvenation, but we are going to volumize a bit. The next thing I look at is I look at the eyes, and I promise I won't poke you here, but I look from the inner colored part or iris of the eye, and I draw a line down. Now, that's anatomically what people talk about. I actually go mid-pupil down because I think a wider mouth is attractive on most people, especially when they're corrected or already have volume in the cheek and a beautiful high cheekbone. And the wider the masseters are, the wider we want the lip to look, because that golden ratio of 1 to 1.1, so this would be 1.61:1 from here to the edge of the lip. And we can talk about that in other videos, and I have one whole video on that to watch. But these golden ratios play a role. Also, the distance from here to the edge of the lip, and then the edge of the lip down, also has that golden ratio of 1.61:1. As this elongates as we age, it looks unusual and it is an aging feature. And some people just genetically might not have the chin projection, and we can of course add volume to the chin with other products, but that plays a role in what we do with the lips. Here our goal is simply to add a little bit of volume. There are some lines here, and this is a superficial product, and this will help with those lines. So that's a little bit of anatomy. There's a lot more on that, but in the interest of time, we'll start injecting and then we'll keep talking. So open up again. Remember, we never touch the needle to the 4x4 because the needle is sterile, and if we touch inside her mouth, we want to change our gloves. So cleanliness is oh so important. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to start injecting. I see that she has a nice central tubercle. There's another tubercle here and here to make three for the upper lip, two tubercles on the lower lip. And I want to fill this area that's a little bit deficient here. So we're going in a little poke here, bevel out this way, and little poke. We're going to the vermilion of the lip, and I'm going to start a little anterior. People love that. And then I fan within the vermilion a little bit in. Okay, there we go. And we're adding a little bit of volume.
Okay, and we add a little bit of volume there. Now I want a little bit of point volume. So a little bit of pointed volume. This is not deep at all. She has a great vermilion border, and what people get freaked out and scared by is when they leave, that vermilion border is a little more projected, okay? So it's a little more projected that way. So what I'm gonna do here, take a second and just change that glove. We palpated the inside. I wanted to see how that was gonna fill. And here, this is the single tubercle on the right of the lower lip, little poke. And we're just superficial. This product flows so easily, you gotta be very careful not to inject too much. Again, we don't see any lower lip lines. I don't want to make the filter columns more prominent here. There's a slight line here, so we can add just a little poke here, a bit of superficial product, and that will just kind of erase that line and prevent that from creasing. Now, I'm gonna come over to the patient's other side and we'll assess it again. It's so important to look at symmetry and point out asymmetries before we inject the patient, because patients don't necessarily see their asymmetries and it's our job to look for them. And after you inject them, they may come back and say, oh, I'm now asymmetric, when in fact, they were asymmetric prior. Okay, and this is superficial because I'm gonna get rid of those lines as this hydrates the lip. And smile, so we always get them to animate and relax. And we did a little bit at the edge here, and we'll add just a little bit at the smile line. Again, this is superficial. This is not deeper into the fat layer like other products. Open up just a little bit. Okay, I'm going to do just a little bit in this inner medial tubercle here. This is sensitive because all the nerves come together here. So poke here, you can feel this one a little bit more, and we're just gonna make that a little more prominent. And that just creates a really nice, pretty look. And then I'm a big fan of pressure. So pressure stops bleeding, stops bruising. And if you have to hold pressure for a couple of minutes, even if you don't see it bleeding at the time, it's worth the time spent. Okay, now, what I'm gonna do is come back. Now I am going to use a little arnica gel, very little massage, but we are gonna massage just to open up a little bit. And you can kind of feel the filler. Not a lot of massage is needed with this product. It's not as cohesive as, say, Voluma. It has a lot less cohesivity, but what that does for you is it allows the product to flow really nice, to hydrate, to get rid of our lines within the lip, and create nice projections. So that's the lip injection with Juvederm Volbella. Okay, so how was your experience getting the lip filler done? Tell us.
It actually wasn't painful at all. I've had my lips done before. It's been probably 5 years. And they used a needle at that time and kind of shoved it in there, and I had a lot of bruising.
Okay.
So this was not painful at all. So I'm very
excellent.
Pleased.
Excellent. Tell us your biggest fear before getting your lip injections. What were you worried about?
I do want it to look natural but full. So I didn't want the duck or the too full. So something
absolutely
natural.
The number one fear of people coming and getting lip injections are that it's gonna look ducky and unnatural. And this product is great because it looks very natural, yet it's long lasting. So for up to a year, people are happy with it. And even you have some product left there, left over. And when you add more in a year, it's just really giving you that much more longevity. So you did amazing, it looks great. Let's look at the after pictures.